can't piss what you came for. Don't you wish you came more? Girl, what you playing for? Come on.
Hi YouTube, this is Harmony. I know I have not been on here for like 2 months. Well, I have, but just not with doing here. But like I always tell you guys, you know, I do videos when I have something to say or something to show you. So I just wanted to give you guys an update on my TWA. This is a 2 week old style, and Tammy will kill me because Tammy told me that I need to be doing my hair like every 3 or 4 days or every week. And that is a hard, practice to pick up because, you know, I've been natural from since 2006, and I find that my hair grows when I leave it alone. Not only that, my styles last so long and my hair is moisturized for such a long period of time that when I do my hair like in 2 or 3 days, or, well, not 2 or 3 days, but in a week's time, I feel like I'm wasting a hairstyle and I'm wasting product. But it's been 2 weeks so that I have not done my hair, and I am going to color it today. And I also want to show you guys how I do a wash and, well, not a wash and go, but because I really don't consider this a wash and go. Adding product to your hair is not a wash and go to me. To me, a wash and go is, you know, you add the product to your hair when you're in the shower, you come out, and you shape your hair and you go. And I have perfected that method, but I'm just not going to do that today. So I'm going to style my hair as I normally do, but I just wanted to show you guys on my TWA. Now that my hair is growing, I have to put it in sections and style it. Now what I really want to bring across to you guys is that everything that I'm doing on my hair, I did it on my hair when it was long. So my methods are really not for a particular hair type. It's really not for a particular length. My method, I'm just trying to bring across to you guys that my methods work on both long and short hair. They work on curly hair. They work on coarse hair. They work on soft hair. Twisting really works on anyone's hair. If you have softer hair, you might have to add a gel. If you want your twist to last longer, add a gel. If you don't want to deal with the frizz, if you don't want to deal with the shrinkage, if you don't want to deal with the expansion, add a gel to your moisturizer. Make sure you add a light gel. Don't add a gel that's thick and gooey. I like to use Kinky Curly. Kinky Curly is very light, and it goes on nicely. And anyone can use Kinky Curly if they're doing twists. It doesn't matter what kind of hair type you have, whether your hair is curly or not. So if you're using twists, if you're doing sets, anyone can use Kinky Curly. But if your hair is not curly, then it's not going to work for you, okay? So I just wanted to give you guys, show how long my hair is now. When I do a twist, you guys will also see it. So the 23rd of this month, see that? The 23rd of this month made 10 months. And, you know, you guys have been following. You knew how short my hair was when I cut it. Last July 23rd.
Come on, let me kiss that. Ooh, I know you missed that. What's wrong? Let me fix that. Twist that, baby.
So that's how long my hair is now. And yeah, the tangling is already a. I don't like the tangling, period. I don't like it, but it is what it is. So what I'm doing today is I'm recoloring my hair. Now, those of you guys always ask me what colors I use, and now that I have a high definition camera, this is my Valentine's Day gift from my boo. I had to invest in a camera. This is what I'll be putting in my hair today. This is Dark and Lovely Red Pot Rhythm. Okay? I have been using this color for years, from since like, what, 99, when Mary J. Blige was the promotional girl. I love this color. This is my favorite color. And I use this color even when I was relaxed. Great color. But this is a new color that came out not too long ago, and I love it. And this is Deep Copper. This is number 365. This is a hot color. This is the color that I have in my hair now. It's a little faded, or you can really see it in the sunlight. But this is the color that I have in my hair now. This is my second to favorite color. I love it. It's a good color for the fall and even for the summer or spring months. But I'm going to go back to Red Hot Rhythm just for a little change. Okay? So that's what I'm doing now. And then I will be showing you guys how I make my curls pop. Some of you have been asking me how I do that. And I know I have videos with me with my hair long in the front showing you, but I also want to show you now that it's short. Because methods are important. Methods are important. It's, you know, when I do videos for you guys, I'm getting my color ready. When I do videos for you guys, I keep in mind that some of you are new. And it's just not enough for me to just say what I've done. I have to demonstrate. Because I'm a visual learner. So I need to see everything that a person is doing if I really want to learn something. I hate when someone comes on YouTube with a pretty hairstyle and she's talking about her hairstyle and she's just showing the style. And I'm like, well, how did you get that? And then that's the end of the video. Like, what's the point? But anyway. Okay, so I'm going to add this to my hair. I love color. I always tell the ladies who contact me about color, color is fine as long as you have your moisture issues under control. If you have dryness issues, if you have breakage issues, get those issues under control first before you're talking about coloring your hair. I advise staying away from blonde because blonde dries your hair out no matter what you do. I don't care how much you moisturize it. It's fly, it's pretty, but it will tear your hair up. So I advise staying away from blonde. Now, there might be some of you who will say, well, Harmony, I dyed my hair blonde and my hair was fine. You are the exception. You are not the rule. Okay? All right. All right, so I'm going to add this to my hair. I just like to start, like, spurting from the root and then work it in to my root. Yes, I have my own methods. I'm just focusing on the roots right now. So what I'm doing is I'm squeezing the color in closed sections in the root of my hair. This stuff is very concentrated, I have to say. Okay. So I'm working that in. Someone asked me, I haven't responded to her yet, why didn't I just part my hair one day when I was coloring it? I would love you to come and put your hands through my hair and then it'll answer your question. When it's time for my hair to be done, I don't want to go through the pulling of parting my hair when it's dry. And when you color your hair, you have to make sure that your hair is dry. So my method works for me. I'm not saying that you have to do it the way that I do it, but it works for me. So what I'm doing now is I am working this in my roots. Not in my scalp, in my roots. I'm not. That's why I'm pulling a little bit. And you guys are going to see my hair is already starting to expand and get fuller because that's what the color does. Now, I just wanted to share something with you guys regarding Texture and Tones by Clairol. You will never see me using that brand of color. And let me tell you why for those of you who don't know. Texture and Tones has an umbrella of different colors on their website, on their main website. Just go to Clairol.com. And you will see that they even have color on there for men. All different types except ours, Texture and Tones. They have a separate site for our stuff. It's called the professional site. Now, if it's a professional site, then that means that's BS, okay? Texture and Tones is no different from any other over-the-counter hair color. It's no different. And we contacted them. Some of the girls, when I announced it on Facebook, which is I Love My Fro, reached out to them. And their response was, The response was that it's on a different site under their professional color. That's foolishness. It makes no sense to me. I will not buy their product. I don't know about you guys, but I wouldn't purchase their product. That's just crap. I mean, to the point where if you go to their main website, they even have products on there for the men, and you're going to tell me that our products have to be on a totally separate site? So that just does not make any sense. So anyway, so this is in my hair. It's fully in my hair. I have worked it through. Okay. It's evenly distributed through my hair, as you guys can see. Okay. And I'm going to wash this out in a few minutes. You have to leave it on for 30 minutes. And I'm going to wash it out. I like this color because there's no dripping. It's really concentrated and it stays like right on your hair. I didn't even have to put a cap on. So that's good. So my hair is going to be red. Okay. So I'm sure you guys have seen the videos of Show Up, Show Out 2012 with ILoveMyFro and Amena Inc. We have teamed up together and I hope to see all you New York City ladies there. This event is totally different from last year. Those of you who attended last year was like a little mini expo. This year is more like a dance party, but we're also going to have performances. There will be no hair demonstrations, not this year, but we're going to have performances, we're going to have giveaways, an hour and a half open bar. We're going to have, Cashel will be there again this year. We also have a group, Ants, which are amazing. They came to perform for us just to give me a taste of what they do. And I was more than pleasantly pleased. I mean, their music is amazing. So anyway, they will be there. We're going to have some spoken word, professional photographers in the house, red carpet treatment, all of that. So you girls come looking your best. And I really hope to see you guys there. What else is going to be going on? Oh, and don't forget about the men. The men are definitely invited. We're reaching out to brothers. So those of you who have, you know, your male friends, or you want to bring your husband or your boyfriend, whoever, come. It's going to be a really nice event. And of course, we have DJ Passion will be in the house again. So it's going to be a whole lot of fun. We're going to have some giveaways for you guys on the swag bags. We already have some great sponsors. We only have Kinky Curly on the site, but we have some great sponsors that have confirmed that they'll be sponsoring the event. We just haven't put their logos up yet because we're just in the works of working all that stuff out behind the scenes. But we have secured some really great sponsors, and, you know, we're looking forward to you guys being there. We're also going to have the vendors. The vendors will also be in the house for some of you who like to shop. So it's going to be a fun, exciting event. And we're also having a fashion show. So those of you who want to be a part of the fashion show, you know, send your photos to showup.showout@yahoo.com and send us your best photos of you rocking your natural hair and also full body photos with you wearing night on the town attire. Keisha G will be directing the fashion show, which is pretty cool. And what else I wanted to say? If you can't make it and you want to be a part of the collage, you can also send your photos to showup.showout@yahoo.com. In any case, if this is your first time hearing about the event, you can visit the event website at www.showupshowout.com. Okay? If you want to be a vendor, if you want to be a sponsor, if you want to volunteer, just let us know, all right? So back to I Love My Fro mode. I'm going to rinse this out, and I will be back with styling my hair, okay? I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye. So I'm sure you guys have seen the videos of Show Up, Show Out 2012 with I Love My Fro and Amena Inc. We have teamed up together, and I hope to see all you New York City ladies there. This event is totally different from last year. Those of you who attended last year, Last year it was like a little mini expo. This year is more like a dance party, but we're also going to have performances. There will be no hair demonstrations, not this year, but we're going to have performances, we're going to have giveaways, an hour and a half open bar. We're going to have, Cashel will be there again this year. We also have a group, Ants, which are amazing. They came to perform for us just to give me a taste of what they do, and I was more than pleasantly pleased. I mean, their music is amazing. So anyway, they will be there. We're going to have some spoken word, professional photographers in the house, red carpet treatment, all of that. So you girls come looking your best, and I really hope to see you guys there. What else is going to be going on? Oh, and don't forget about the men. The men are definitely invited. We're reaching out to brothers, so those of you who have, you know, your male friends, or you want to bring your husband or your boyfriend, whoever, come. It's going to be a really nice event. And of course, we have DJ Passion will be in the house again. So it's going to be a whole lot of fun. And we're going to have some giveaways for you guys on the swag bags. We already have some great sponsors. We only have Kinky Curvy on the site, but we have some great sponsors that have confirmed that they'll be sponsoring the event. We just haven't put their logos up yet because we're just in the works of working all that stuff out behind the scenes. But we have secured some really great sponsors, and you know, we're looking forward to you guys being there. We're also going to have the vendors. The vendors will also be in the house for some of you who like to shop. So it's going to be a fun, exciting event. And we're also having a fashion show. So, those of you who want to be a part of the fashion show, you know, send your photos to showup.showout@yahoo.com and send us your best photos of you rocking your natural hair and also full body photos with you wearing night on the town attire. Keisha G will be directing the fashion show, which is pretty cool. And what else I wanted to say? If you can't make it and you want to be a part of the collage, you can also send your photos to showup.showout@yahoo.com. In any case, if this is your first time hearing about the event, you can visit the event website at www.showupshowout.com. Okay? If you want to be a vendor, if you want to be a sponsor, if you want to volunteer, just let us know, all right? So, back to I Love My Fro mode. I'm going to rinse this out, and I will be back with styling my hair, okay? I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye. Hi, YouTube. So, this is Harmony again, and I have washed the color out of my hair, and I have detangled in sections. I used the... give me 1 minute, guys. I used the conditioner to detangle. This is the conditioner that comes with the color. I ran out of my onion honey hemp, so I used this one, and it worked great. So it took me like 20 minutes to detangle my hair. That's because my hair was not tangled. The longer I keep in my style, the more my hair gets tangled. So what I'll be doing from now on, even as my hair gets longer, I'll be doing my hair every 2 weeks. It was a breeze to detangle my hair. So I detangled my hair with the wide tooth comb. See guys, I'm still using the same stuff as I did when my hair was long. So I used my wide tooth comb with the conditioner in my hair. I detangled, and then I just put twists in my hair. Now, the twists are important when you are putting in a gel because you need the extra water to activate the kinky curly custard. And the twist holds in the extra water. If I was just to tangle my hair like this, and I went and I lotioned my skin and I changed my clothes, the tips of my hair would already be dry. And some of you are having problems with the kinky curly because your hair is not wet enough, okay? So anyway, I'm using my the kinky curly custard and, of course, my shea butter whip. This is orange vanilla, okay? And I'm just going to spritz some of my black tea treatment on my hair. You see my label is all messed up, and because I use my stuff. So what I'm going to do is just take this out, and it's still nice and wet. Just spritz it a little bit, some black tea. Take a little. I'm just going to show you guys how much product I'm using. Okay, some of you are using too much Kinky Curly Custard. See, that's what I'm using. And I'm going to mix that. Oh, I'm creating a mess right here because my shea butter whip is not open. Yeah, I always say this is reality TV. Okay, so I'm taking the Kinky Curly Custard, that much, okay, and my shea butter whip. Only the reason why I'm adding the shea butter whip is for extra moisture and to eliminate the crunchy feel that you get from the Kinky Curly Custard, okay? And there's some of you who have told me this method has really worked for you. So now I'm just going to rake it in. I'm just going to rake it in, and all the Kinky Curly Custard does, like any other gel, it defines what you already have. Kinky Curly Custard or no other gel, I'm going to add just a little bit more Kinky Curly Custard. Kinky Curly Custard or no other gel creates curls. It just defines what you naturally already have. So if you don't have curly hair, you can use the Kinky Curly Custard. You can do this and then twist your hair. You can use the same product and then you can put some really nice two-strand twists in your hair and your hair would take on the form of the twist and make your hair wavy or curly. Okay? And so that's what I am going to do with the rest of my hair. I'm just going to do another section and when I come back, I'll just show you guys a little bit of how I shape. How I shape my hair. When my hair was long, I don't have to shape it, but now that it's short, you know, I still have to do a little bit of work. So that's the black tea leave-in. You guys don't have to use the black tea leave-in if you don't want to. If you find that you are running out, your hair is not wet enough, just have a spray bottle on hand. Okay? And that's that. And then you have to rake it through. You don't scrunch in a Kinky Curly Custard, meaning you don't take the product and go like this. That's not really going to do anything to your hair, especially if you have coarse hair. You have to literally do the work to have the style. Okay? Alright, and sometimes my ends get a little puffy. So what I do for that is I just take a little bit more of Kinky Curly and I just really focus on my ends. Okay, I like the Kinky Curly Custard. I used to use Miss Jessie's, but I like the Kinky Curly Custard because it's clear. And it gives better definition than Miss Jessie's. It's cheaper and it's concentrated. Miss Jessie's is expensive. It's a pudding. You have to work harder to get it in. And it doesn't last as long, in my opinion. That's just my opinion. Some of you love it. Everything is for everybody. Okay? Alright. So that's all I'm going to do. Okay, I'm going to rake this in. I did this 2 weeks ago and I didn't do a video because I figured, is it necessary? But then people started asking me how I got my hair like this. And I only have videos with my hair longer. With me, you know, doing it with long hair. But I just want to show you guys that I'm still using the same methods. The only thing that that has changed for me with the TWA, I have perfected a wash and go, and I'm gonna have to work out a way to film that because that has to be done in the shower. So, because I really want to show you guys, but I'm gonna do that when my hair gets longer, that you can actually perfect a wash and go in your hair without coming out and putting in product, and that's on any hair type. Okay. So this is the last section I'm gonna do, and then I'm out. Okay, I got stuff on my shirt. And just rake it through. And the color took. You can really see it in the sunlight. You really can't see it in here. But that's my hair. Oh, and let me finish my other statement. And the second thing is, I just have to do my hair every 2 weeks. I mean, it was a breeze for me to detangle my hair. And last time I did it doing the same style, it took me an hour. But that's because I didn't do my hair for a month. Now, I only can get away with that in the winter months and in the cooler months. In the summertime, I have to do my hair more often. If I am working out, okay, I definitely have to do my, I do a lot of wash and goes when I'm working out. And that's how I learned to perfect it. So anyway, guys, I am done with the front of my hair. I'm going to finish the rest of it and I will be back, okay? Bye-bye. So hi, YouTube, I'm back. And all the product is in my hair. Now, usually at this stage, I usually shake my hair, but I don't have too much hair to work with. So I'm wetting my hands, right? And I'm just going to work this a little bit more through my hair, okay? Now, let's say if your hair was really short, I mean, like you have a real TWA. This is a TWA growing out. You would not part your hair in sections. It makes no sense. You would just take the product that I just showed you guys, and you would put it in your hand, and you would work it through your hair just like this. Your fingers are literally touching your scalp. Okay, you're not just going like this. You really have to do it with force. And your fingers are like raking your scalp. And that is what's going to bring out your curls. And then what you would do is you would shape your hair. Okay? Now, I need a trim. I have to go to Tammy for a trim because I'm not going to do it myself. Which is, Tammy is the owner of iMeta Inc. I need a trim, so my hair is going to be a little uneven. But see, that's where the shrinkage comes in. Don't sleep on shrinkage. Trust me, shrinkage gives our hair style and shape. Well, shrinkage gives our hair shape, okay? So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to shape this as much as I can, just to loosen it a bit, all right? And then I'm just going to shape. Gently shape. I don't want to create frizz. But you guys can already see that my hair is starting to shrink. Okay. You guys can see that. Always make sure you get your edges. Okay. And so that's that. And as I told you guys, my hair is shorter. A little short. Starting to catch up, but it's a little shorter in the front because I cut it too short, but it's starting to catch up now. So I need a trim. So what's going to happen with this is, still looks good though. What's going to happen with this is I have a little fairy knot, see? What's going to happen is this is just going to shrink and shape up more on its own. I'm already getting a tail. You guys can see that, right? My hair was like really full down here, and it's softer. It's the softest part of my hair, so it takes time for it to shrink up and stuff. But I'm gonna run errands, and I'm just gonna let this dry, air dry, and call it a day. Okay, so that's how I make my style pop. Okay, I hope you guys are doing well. Summertime is here. Those of you who are coming to show up, show out, I hope you're getting your outfits ready. Come looking your best, okay? And let me just put my earrings on. Actually, I'm wearing my t-shirt from last year, Respect the Kink. I don't know if you guys can see it. Yeah, that's the t-shirt from last year. Anyway, so guys, that's it. So that's how I make my curls pop. It's a pretty easy process. This took me like about what? If I didn't color my hair, it would probably take me like an hour. Okay? So anyway, I will talk to you guys later. And have a wonderful weekend. The night I let you know. Baby, tonight, the night we lose control.